Well, it's October 16th, Saturday. We haven't had a sweet feed in a while, so I figured I'd get you one out. There's been a bunch of stuff, different stuff going on lately, and so today I am on my way up north, up by Fort Collins, up to where we have our Goose lease. We've got about 200 and some odd acres that we lease every year for goose hunting. Now, you know, when we talk about whether it's elk or deer up in the high country, up on the national forest, you know, a lot of times, in general, the habitat's pretty consistent. We know that, you know, the bedding areas are going to be in such a place, and the good foraging areas are generally going to be in such and such a place, and the water is going to be over here or over there. Now, each year we can have different conditions. You know, sometimes the meadows are a little drier, sometimes they're a little wetter, sometimes the forage is a little better here or there. And we talked about that during some of the sweet feeds in elk season, about how to evaluate some of the habitat areas. But when we're talking about goose hunting, and we're using agriculture fields, or we're talking about, like I have been getting ready for, is whitetails in Kansas. When we're talking about using agriculture areas, and hunting in and around agricultural areas, we can have major shifts in the quality of the habitat that we're hunting that could end up, or likely will end up, changing and, you know, affecting what goes on, what type of wildlife use we get in those areas. So that's what we're doing today, is kind of going up and taking a look and see what our fields look like. It was all planted in corn earlier this year. Unfortunately, I think all the corn has been chopped, which means it's pretty clean. It's dirt and a couple corn stalks. And then we've got to find out whether or not the farmer's going to just plow it all under and chisel plow it and turn it all into a dirt field. Because the field to the south of us was corn, but it almost looks like they're going to combine that. Well, if they combine that field and they chisel plow, or just they already chopped ours, we're done. Our season is going to be rough, just to say the least, because all the birds are just going to pile into that combine field where there's going to be more food. Typically in a chop field, there's very little food. So that's kind of what I want to look at today, see exactly what we're dealing with and what the potential is going to be for this season. I have a feeling it's going to be a tough one. For some of our whitetail stuff out in Kansas, same thing. The change in agriculture, major changes in agriculture, looks like it may end up shifting some of the deer movement. Now, in some areas, the change is going to be good, very, very good. We're going to pull deer right smack dab across us, right where we want them. However, there's a couple other fields that were planted earlier this year. Into winter wheat, they're going to be very problematic, because they're actually going to pull deer away from our properties. So, when you're dealing with wildlife species that are utilizing or living in and around agriculture, understand that each year the changes in agriculture and how the farmer or landowner plants his crops and how he harvests them can have a huge impact on what your success or potential success could look like through the year. So, if you have the ability to, sometimes it's worth having a good relationship with that landowner or the farmer and working with them through the year to see, you know, if they'd be open to the idea that of leaving some areas for you and for the wildlife for hunting purposes. Sometimes, like we have in our goose lease, the farmer isn't really interested in it. He's just going to do what he's going to do, and we're just pretty much stuck with it. So, anyway, we'll talk more about this. We'll have some sweet feeds coming up on deer. We'll have some more sweet feeds coming up on waterfowl. But anyway, that's what I'm doing today. Running some errands, and I'm going to swing up, check that field, see what we look like for this year.